What's up, guys? Rexon34 back here with another video, and today I'm going to be talking about Legend of Blue Eyes and if it's investable. So yeah, it's a pretty talked about question, but first of all, I want to remind you guys to like the video, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. And yeah, let's get into this. Make sure you guys check out my TCG Player affiliate link if you guys are buying cards on TCG Player, because when you do, it supports me and my eBay link as well. If you're buying some on eBay, use my link. Buy whatever you want on eBay, and it comes back to me and supports the channel. So, pretty cool. And yeah, that's it for the intro. Let's just get into some LOB discussion. So, LOB obviously is Legend of Blue Eyes. I've had questions about this, and obviously you guys have heard about Legend of Blue Eyes. We're going to keep this angle the whole video. Yeah, we're not even going over here. I obviously have not even cleaned up right here. There's just stuff everywhere. But I was just like, let's talk about some LOB. I got a question about LOB and if people, you should buy LOB first edition and if it's worth it. Of course it is worth it. It depends on what you're getting. So Legend of Blue Eyes, first edition, you want to buy first edition. If you're thinking about investing, if you're thinking about, increasing in value of your cards. So I know a lot of people, they don't care about increasing the value of their cards. They are just purely in it for, you know, nostalgia, or they just like the cards or whatever. And if you're doing that, clearly you want to go the unlimited route, because unlimited is just much cheaper. It's way cheaper. Like even opening the box, like the box we opened was about $800, $900, $1,000. The first edition box is $7,000, $6,000, $5,000. You know, probably not. It's gonna be hard to find one for $5,000, but everyone's asking like $7,000 now. But it's a lot cheaper. So, and if you're buying the singles, it's $20, $10, $5. Commons are $1, 50 cents, you know, 10 cents, whatever. So you can buy that stuff super cheap. So if you want, if you're just in it for, you know, the love of the cards, just buy the unlimited because it's the same. It just doesn't say first edition. But if you're looking in it for investing purposes, you have to go first edition. And what is the best first edition LOB to buy? Is it singles? Is it raw singles, PSA, PSA 9s, you know, sealed product? For me, this is my, I guess you can say it's my opinion, but also there's some facts supported it. You want to get sealed boxes. The best investment is a sealed, for LOB, sealed first edition booster box. And right now it's wavy, or first print or whatever. I guess first print is a word that means nothing. So probably stick with wavy when you're discussing it. So wavy, Legend of Blue Eyes. For whatever reason, wavy appears to have less boxes printed. So I'm not an expert. I don't have the print numbers, but it appears that they're, according to, you know, a bunch of people like Gezi and, you know, everyone who is peddling glass. You got it confused there. But yeah, Gezi, about 33% of LOB is, this is approximation, based off of PSA population. So like, based on like, if there's a Trihorn Dragon graded, you know, 100 times, like 33 of them are wavy usually. And then, you know, like 67-ish are glossy. So there's way more glossy than there are wavy, usually. So that's where that one third comes from. So it appears that there's about one third of LOB is wavy. So obviously one third compared to two thirds is much rarer than two thirds, even though they are both first edition and they're both Legend of Blue Eyes. It's up for debate if that should matter at all, but it does. In the market, it matters. First edition wavy goes for more right now because people realize that it is harder to find wavy. But what is wavy versus glossy? Wavy is just how the card stock looks. So the cards are exactly the same in terms of text on the card and all that stuff. You know, they still say first edition. They still say Legend of Blue Eyes. They still have the same name, same text. You know, it's the same card. It's not like in Pokemon, but there's Shadowless. Shadowless literally looks different. It has a different, you know, it's a different color. Everything about it's different. So, that when it comes to wavy versus glossy, it's really not different, but yet the rarity, I guess you could say, of wavy is, it's more rare. So that's why people are paying a little bit more for it. But back to what I was saying about Legend of Blue Eyes. Legend of Blue Eyes, booster box. That is the best investment you can make. when and wavy at this point. So a wavy box looks different than a glossy box because of the larger text, I believe, is glossy. I'm not 100% sure, but you can tell. There is a way to tell. Look it up. Yugioh Tube made a video on it. I believe some other people did. So, and then just ask somebody that knows if you need to figure it out. But this is why booster boxes are the best and for an investment purpose. Booster box has that, it's sealed, you know, it's a sealed product. It has that mystery factor about it. It could have the blue eyes in it. It could have an error, you know, it could have error packs. There could be 24 holos in there. You know, it has that mystery factor. Then the fact that booster boxes, the supply of booster boxes is always going down. Booster boxes, you're not going to get more first edition booster boxes. It's impossible. You can say this about, you know, cards too, singles. You can say, well, you know, they're not printing any more first edition cards. But usually when we talk about investing in singles, it's with PSA. So with PSA graded 10s, that's what you really care about when you invest. Because if you invest in a PSA 9, it's just not really an investment usually. Unless the card just extremely spikes at 10, then the 9 will probably go up with it a little bit. But I mean, it's going to be like this, you know, flying up at 10 and just kind of creeping up at 9. So the 10s are the investment piece, and 10s can go up. So there's not actually more blue eyes. There's not actually more blue eyes on the market, but there are more 10s as more graded. So there's not going to be too many more graded, but it will go up. So there will go from 80-ish right now, 80, I think there's like 84 or something, but Gezi goes on this big thing about, you know, two of them are misgraded, mislabeled, and you know, all this stuff. So there's around 80-ish. Ungraded. So 80 now, maybe in 10 years, there'll be 90 or 100, maybe more. But in 10 years from now, a booster box, there's going to be 10, 20, 30, 40 less than there is now. There's not going to be any more. And as you open those, or as those are open, more blue eyes, more PSA 10 blue eyes. So the blue eyes price is going to be still not going to go down, but it's going to, you know, it's like, oh, more blue eyes. So it kind of, the market's not kind of, you know, exploding. But when you open a booster box, the other ones that are not opened, they just got rarer. There are less of them. So booster box investing in LOB first edition is a no-brainer to me. I think the 7,000, honestly, the 7,000 price point that people are asking to me is low. I mean, I know right now it's probably pretty fair, but in about 5 years, an LOB booster box, it's going to be way, way, way over 7,000, in my opinion. And I say that because you can't linearly compare Pokemon to Yu-Gi-Oh! Because they're not the same thing. But when I say linear, I mean like something that happened to Pokemon isn't going to happen in Yu-Gi-Oh! Exactly the same. But Pokemon and Yu-Gi-Oh! They're both TCGs. They're both, you know, they're Japanese TCGs. They have a TV show. They have a card game. They're very similar. Very, very similar. Pokemon is a little bit different because Pokemon is a huge brand and everybody knows Pokemon. So, like, you can talk to anybody and almost everyone has heard of Pokemon unless they're, like, 60 plus years old. You know, if you're 40 or younger, you know what Pokemon is. You know, you've seen it. You've heard of a Charizard. You've heard of whatever. Yu-Gi-Oh! Is very popular, but it's not to that level. It doesn't have those video games that people are still wanting to buy in their 30s. There's not like five-year-olds, you know, I want to get the new Sword and Shield game, you know, all that. Pokemon has that going for it. Yu-Gi-Oh! Doesn't really have, it has some good games coming out, but like, it's not the same level. And then there's not just, like, the newer cards are really, like, you know, the shiny Charizard fad. Like, people went crazy for that. Everyone was buying those cards. That's not really happening in Yu-Gi-Oh! Like, I kind of like how the Prismatics showed up. I do like Prismatics. It's just, they're not doing it quite as well. Like, I like the rarity factor, but they need to do something for, like, collectors, I think. I think that if they put, like, a Blue Eyes Prismatic in a set, I think that that would be crazy. I think a lot of people would want to buy that because of the Blue Eyes. You know, kind of like they do with Charizard and Pokemon. So, yeah, so that's kind of a tangent, but basically Pokemon and Yu-Gi-Oh! So I was comparing those two. Why I think the booster box for Legend of Blue Eyes is going to go way up. It's not going to spike. I mean, you know, it's going to be years. It's an investment. We're talking about an investment. Investment is not 1 year. An investment is not 6 months. An investment is 3, 5 years, 10 years. You know, a long time. So why do I think that Legend of Blue Eyes booster boxes and singles as well, they're going to go up too, especially in 10. I think that's going to happen because if you look at Pokemon, if you look at that base set booster box, 3 years ago, 2 years ago, probably like 3 years ago, $10,000. So like pretty close to what an LOB box is now, you know, $7,000 to $10,000. 3 years later, there's been a lot of things. There's been, you know, there's been Pokemon Go came out around then. There's been the Pokemon movie came out, you know, Detective Pikachu, $90,000 to $100,000 for a booster box, 3 years. So I'm not saying you can't compare. You can't say, okay, so that means in 3 years, LOB is going to go up by 10 times. So it's going to be 70,000. Can't say that. It's not gonna, it doesn't work like that. But that trend, that huge increase over years, several years, I just feel like it's a no-brainer. And it's not just one example. Pokemon did that. But if you go back to the older game, Magic the Gathering, you look at sealed product, it is insanely priced. Now, it's pretty cool because Magic came out in 93, so it's the oldest. It's, you know, 27 years old this year. Pokemon is 99, so it's, you know, 21 years old. And then you got Yu-Gi-Oh!, which is the youngster, 18 years old this year. So you can kind of look at those other two games and you see what happens. With Magic, the alpha sealed stuff, the beta sealed stuff, the unlimited sealed stuff, all those first three sets, which are basically all, from my understanding of Magic, those are all like the same set kind of, except they're like, I think Unlimited had a different color border and then they were cut differently on alpha and beta, I believe. But they all had like similar cards or the same cards maybe. They had the Power 9 in there basically, the big nine of the pulls. Those sealed packs are insane. Like, I don't even know what they go for. Like, one pack is like $2,500, you know, $3,000. It's even more than the first edition Pokemon stuff. And if I'm looking at that as a Yu-Gi-Oh guy, I'm thinking LOB is the alpha, the beta, the base set of Yu-Gi-Oh. And I'm thinking, when I'm comparing it to Pokemon, I'm like, well, Pokemon is so big, like maybe that's why it went up. Then I go to Magic. Magic is not big. Magic is big for, you know, the people that played it. There's nothing else. There's no video games. There's no movies. There's nothing like, there's no, like, anything else besides the card game bringing up the value. And the value is still insane. So with Yu-Gi-Oh! Having, you know, an iconic show, it having, you know, it has a current card game, which is still pretty strong, going right now. It has shows, it has games still coming out, it has Duel Links, which is, you know, done pretty well, and they've even changed up the new rules to bring back, you know, new people with the new stuff. It's just a no-brainer to me that if you want to invest in LOB first edition, there's almost nothing to worry about. You buy that box, you set it aside, and in a few years, you're going to make your easy money on it. But obviously, the problem with investing in LOB is that it's $7,000. So if you don't have an extra $7,000 to invest, and I mean, let me say this. You should not invest in it unless, of course, you have, you know, if you only have $7,000 and you want a quick flip or you need to get your money back quickly, do not buy that because it's a year, it's years, you know, it's 3, 4, 5 years before you get big returns, potentially. I mean, it's possible you could buy it and it spikes all of a sudden, but as you don't want to risk, you know, $7,000 on that. But to me, that booster box is a no-brainer buy to invest in. That's my personal opinion based on how Magic the Gathering and base set Pokemon have done. Secondly, I believe the guy when he asked was talking about singles. So when buying singles for LOB First Edition, I would try to avoid played copies and stuff like that because that stuff will eventually increase, but it's just much harder to get your value out of played copies, light play copies. And even near mint, I'd be looking for these do not exist anymore. Raw mint copies. Those do not exist. But if you can find those, obviously you want to get those and grade them. But PSA 10s are what you're going to want for best for an investment purposes. You want to have that PSA 10 that people will buy. And even these days, you're going to want to look, you want to be careful with what 10s you buy because personally, I'm not a huge strong 10 guy, but I know a lot of people are strong 10 guys. So if you have a weak 10, they're not going to be, it's not going to sell for as much. So if you buy your 10s, make sure, you know, be careful. Don't buy anything that got misgraded or something like that. But yeah, 10s are a very good investment. 9s are a great value for what you buy. They're much lower, but they're not going to go up as much. So for me, I think LOB, first edition, booster box, slash booster packs. Booster packs as well will be very big, because if you look at Pokemon and Magic, their first edition or their alpha packs, or I'm trying to think if alpha's weird. I don't even know if they had a box, but like beta had a box, I know that. That stuff in individual booster packs is selling really well. So if you buy a first edition LOB pack and sit on it, that's still a good investment. While it's not a booster box, a booster box is the best, obviously. If you have an unbroken booster box, if you have an unbroken booster case, you're insane. Like, just sit on that thing, because that's going to be big, big money. Because the less that's been opened, the better, like, in terms of old stuff. So, that's about it. I went on for a long time. I didn't realize I had that much to say. I had nothing. This was all just out of my winging it brain, you know. I think about this stuff all the time, so that's why it was so easy. But I hope that helped out for you guys who are wondering. I know a lot of you guys, you know, you guys are big LOB guys. You guys know all this stuff. But personally, I'm thinking LOB first edition booster boxes are the best investment. Then if you get PSA 10s, those are always going to be popular as long as Yu-Gi-Oh! Is a strong game. And even on past that, because, you know, the collector's market is very strong right now. So that's it for today. I'll see you guys later. Peace.
Oh, yes! No, upside down, cyber dark.